Hello guys, now I am in this lecture I will teach you about the how you can do lighting design calculation of emergency lighting. So in emergency lighting we will not care about the value of the mu node. It doesn't matter how much will be the mu node, but as per the standard your emergency lux should be 25% of the total lux. It means if we have an lux of 100, a requirement of 100 lux in a total system, then in emergency system we only need 25 lux. So 25% of lux level is required for emergency lighting design. So I have to make a lighting system on this room, and then I create some lighting scenes and I am making an emergency lighting design. How we can create it? Let's see. I can go right click on this one, on this drawing, and edit room geometry. So now I can go right click and draw a rectangle. So I can click on this one and I can make the rectangle like this one. So I can this one make this room. So I can go ahead here and I can say okay. Due to the latest changes, the calculations and the following are invalid. Okay, I can discard all the other way. I can make it now room this one. So this room has been created. I can go and paste and field arrangement, and I can make some any arrangement. So I can, it doesn't matter. So my room has been created. So I have no concern how much lux in this room. I have already teach you in the previous lectures about the room and the IEC standards of the rooms. So I am now here in this lecture I am now teaching you about the emergency lighting. Let me show you. If I have this light and this light, and this light is my emergency light, if then how I can create this one. So this is a full lighting design. So I can make a selection tool and right click on the this one and split my lighting. So my luminaries has been splitted. Now I can select individual. Let me, I can press the shift button. I can select this. I can select this one. Let me show you that this one. I can also this one. So these four lights I want only 1, 2, 3, 4 for my emergency lighting design. So I can select this one and I can right click and add to control group. So I am making a new control group for this one. So I can click on it. So this is my control group 2 for this lighting design. So I can go to the control group and right click and add to light scene. So this is my new light scene, these four lights. So I can click on it. Now my new light scene has been created. So now what to do? I can go to the start calculation. And I can include the luminaries of the light scene too. If I do not need this one, I can also uncheck this one. So I can say okay. Now calculation is going on for two rooms. So let me show you the 3D room. And now this is a 3D. Let me show you. So you can see that only four lights are in the lighting conditions. So only these four what I have selected is my in my design. So now I check this one, my single sheet output. So this is blur, so I cannot check this one from there. So from where I can check this one? So I can go here, I can go to the lights. This is my outputs. This is a projects. I can check this one. This is luminary partners or someone. I can go my room, and these are my input protocol, luminary part list, luminary files. These are the, my light scenes. I have a light scene 2, so I can click on the summary. So it will provide me these of the lights I have chosen for my emergency lighting design. So this is basically a work plan. E average is 12. So that's fine, I think so. And if the mu node is, doesn't matter for the emergency lighting design, you can check as per your requirement that mu node is as per 25% or not of your actual room. So this is basically an my lighting design, emergency lighting design in dialux. So thank you very much, and we come with another lecture. Thank you.